Hi, I'm Amanda, and this is Danny. We're here to talk about the vault and the power-ups.
Wait, power-ups? I totally didn't see that coming.
Anyway, the vault is where teams can trade in power cubes for power-ups. It is located at the rear of the Alliance Station. Teams receive the power cubes through the exchange and place them in the vault. For more information on the exchange and how it works, be sure to watch Kate and Malcolm's video on the portals in the exchange.
Notice that there are three columns in the vault, one for each of the three power-ups. Two of the power-ups have multiple power levels, so teams will need to strategically decide how and when to play each power-up. Power cubes are placed into the vault with the logo side up. Sensors within the vault detect inserted power cubes and indicate power cube and power-up status on the above lights. Each cube inserted for a power-up will illuminate single nodes, and when the power-up is played, all nodes for that power-up will change to the Alliance color. Teams must plan their cube placement carefully, since once a power cube is placed into the vault, it cannot be removed for any reason. There's some cool technology at work here. Make sure you check out the video about Rockwell Automation's involvement in this year's field.
There are three power-ups available in each match for each Alliance: Force, Boost, and Levitate. When a team is ready to play a power-up, they push the corresponding button. Teams will want to pay attention, though, as each power-up is only available once during the match for each Alliance. There are also rules about when power-ups can be played and when they can't, so make sure to read the manual carefully. Levitate requires three power cubes and can be played at any point during the match. Levitate gives one robot a free climb at the end of the match.
Force and Boost are closely related. Both have three levels of power, so teams will want to make sure they play them accordingly. Both can be played only once per Alliance during the match, regardless of the power level, and they cannot be played simultaneously. Teams will need to read the manual carefully to know when Force and Boost can't be played. Force gives an Alliance ownership of either their switch, the scale, or both for 10 seconds. Boost gives an Alliance a boosted score on either their switch, the scale, or both for 10 seconds.
Wait, Danny, those sound very similar. Does Boost give an Alliance ownership?
No. Boost will only boost the score of an element that your Alliance owns. So if you don't have ownership, Boost will have no effect.
Got it, Danny Downer. Don't forget, power cubes are worth points in the vault, regardless of the power-ups played. This even includes columns with used power-ups.
The strategies around the power-ups are my favorite part of the game this year.
Agreed. I can't wait to see the team's strategies.
Have fun.
And good luck.